So in the last section we have obtained the solution as cos ka equal to p sin alpha a by alpha a plus cos alpha a. I am writing that equation here. The solution we have obtained the solution as cos ka is equal to p sin alpha a by alpha a plus cos alpha a, where p is given by p equal to m v0 b a by h bar square. Now we will find the value of p for two extreme cases. Now consider V0B as infinite. If V0B is infinite, the potential, the height of potential is very high and width is very high. That means the electrons cannot penetrate through this barrier. It should be confined in inside this region. This region is having a width of A. So it is having a width of the order of atomic dimension, so that electron will be confined within a particular atom if V0B is infinite. If V0B is infinite, then P is infinite. That means P tends to infinity. When P tends to infinity, this solution will have a significant value only when this term is equal to 0. So when P tends to infinity, sin alpha A, that should be equal to 0. That means alpha A is equal to n pi, where n equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. Or we can write alpha equal to n pi by A. We have alpha square equal to 2m E by h bar square, or E equal to h bar square alpha square by 2m. So when alpha equal to n pi, we have the energy as h bar square by 2m into n square pi square by a square, or energy as n square pi square h bar square by 2m a square. This energy equation we already know for a particle in a box. Here the box is having dimension a, which is of the order of atomic size. So in this case, the particle will be confined within the box of atomic dimension, and it will be having discrete energy values. Since E proportional to n square, so it will be having discrete energy levels, but it will be confined in a region of atomic dimension. So this is the case with the particle in a box. Now we will consider V0B very, very small. If it is very, very small, or V0B tends to 0. If the potential barrier is very small or width is very small, if V0 is very small, we can write E greater than V0. If V0 tends to 0, then E greater. That means it will behave like a free particle. It can move freely anywhere within the crystal. So it is equivalent to, it should be equivalent to free electron model. If L is the dimension of crystal, then it can, the electron can move freely within the region, or inside that region V0 is, the potential inside this region is 0. So it should be like free electron. It is similar to free electron theory. We can prove that when V0B tends to 0, that means P tends to 0. When P tends to 0, this equation becomes 0. So we can write it as cos ka equal to, this term is 0, so cos ka equal to cos alpha a, or we can write ka equal to alpha a, or alpha equal to k. If alpha equal to k, then the energy will be h bar square k square by 2m. This is the energy for a free particle. For free electron model, we have obtained the energy as h bar square k square by 2m. So when V0B is negligibly small, then it is like free electron theory. So the energy level E versus K, here E proportional to K square. So in that case, we have studied the relation between E and K. So the graph will be like this. It will be a parabola like this. This is energy E, then this is K. So here E proportional to K square. This is for free electron inside a crystal. It is same as free electron theory. Now we will draw the graph showing the variation of this equation. Y-axis we are taking the function, y-axis we are taking this function, and the x-axis I am taking alpha A. X-axis alpha A is taken, and y-axis we are taking P sin alpha A by alpha A plus cos alpha A. So when alpha A is 0, when alpha A is 0, this is alpha A, sin alpha A by alpha A. This term will be 1 by applying the limit. Limit alpha A tends to 0, sin alpha A by sin alpha A will be 1. So it will be P plus cos 0, 1. So we will be getting maximum at this point. Then as alpha A increases, the variation is like this. For minus value, we can write the variation like this. This is the variation of P sin alpha, the right hand side of this equation with the alpha A. But we all the values of this function are not acceptable because this is equal to cos ka. So it should match with the left hand side, cos ka. We know that the maximum value of cos ka is plus 1 and minimum value of cos ka is minus 1. Cos ka varies between plus 1 and minus 1. So all these values of this function are not acceptable. Only the values which varies between plus 1 and minus 1 are acceptable. So I am taking this maximum value of cos ka plus 1 here, the minimum value of cos ka minus 1 here. So the acceptable values of this function are between plus 1 and minus 1. Now, here the function is having minus 1 value. So, value of alpha A for this minus 1 value, this alpha A, that should be pi. When alpha A equal to pi, sin pi is 0, then cos pi is minus 1. So, this function value will be minus 1 when alpha A equal to pi. Then this plus 1 we will be getting when alpha A equal to 2 pi. When alpha A equal to 2 pi, cos 2 pi plus 1 sin 2 pi is 0. So this term becomes 0, 0 plus 1 plus 1. Then here minus 1, this is 3 pi. Then plus 1, this will be 4 pi and so on. Similarly, on the left hand side, cos plus pi is minus 1. Cos minus pi is cos pi. So, it is also minus 1. So, here this value, this is minus pi. Then this one will be minus 2 pi. And this one will be minus 3 pi and so on. So, the acceptable values are between this plus 1 and minus 1. So from here to here, the value is acceptable. So from here to here, the value of alpha A is acceptable. So this one is allowed region of alpha A. So this region, from here to here, it is between plus 1 and minus 1. So this also will be, this region also will be allowed region. This is allowed region. Then between plus 1 and minus 1. This region is also allowed region. That means the region between these two, here this one is forbidden region. This is forbidden. So no electron can have an alpha value between these two. Alpha, we know that alpha square is equal to 2m E by h bar square. If there is a selection for alpha value, then there is a selection for energy. That means all the energy values are not possible. We are having some range of energy possible for the electron wave function and some range of energy they are not possible. That forbidden energy bands are called energy gaps or forbidden energy gap. So this region is, this value of alpha is not possible. Like that on the left hand side we can draw like this. This is allowed region and this region is forbidden. Then between this plus 1 and minus 1, this is allowed region. Between that forbidden region, here it is allowed region, and between that there is forbidden region. So this discontinuity in energy appears when here it is minus 1. From here to here it is not possible. So the first discontinuity appears when alpha A equal to pi. This is appearing when alpha A equal to pi. Then this function value of this right hand side is minus 1. Value of this right hand side is minus 1. When this function is equal to minus 1, we can write cos ka as minus 1. Cos ka is minus 1 when ka equal to pi. Plus pi or minus pi. Next is plus 1. The next discontinuity is occurring when it is plus 1. From here to here, it is not possible. So the second discontinuity appears when this is equal to plus 1. So cos ka is plus 1 when plus or minus t is equal to 2 pi. It is minus 1 when plus or minus 3 pi and so on. So at these points, the discontinuity occurs. Or we can write k equal to plus or minus pi by a. Then plus or minus 2 pi by a. Plus or minus 3 pi by a. The discontinuity in energy occurs. So this energy discontinuity is occurring at regions where k equal to plus or minus pi by a, k equal to plus or minus 2 pi by a, or plus or minus 3 pi by a. Now we will draw the energy E versus k. Now we will draw the energy versus k graph. Y-axis we are taking energy E and the x-axis we are taking k. For a free electron, we know that the energy versus k graph is a parabola like this. In free electron theory, we have drawn a parabola. Here, the discontinuity occurs where k equal to plus pi by a, and the first discontinuity occurs where k equal to plus pi by a and minus pi by a. Second discontinuity of k, energy occurs at k equal to 2 pi by a and minus 2 pi by a. Third discontinuity occurs where k equal to 3 pi by a, here minus 3 pi by a, and so on. I am writing this plus pi by a, then so energy here it is a parabola, and the first discontinuity occurs at k equal to pi by a. So here it is when k equal to pi by a. We have shown that alpha a range of alpha A is not possible, that means a range of E value is not possible. So the first discontinuity occurs when k equal to pi by A. Here this is the energy level, and corresponding to that range of alpha A, we will be having a range of energy which is not possible. So this range of energy is not possible. Here the discontinuity occurs, and the second region, the variation of energy starts from here, and this is second region. Then on left hand side we can draw like this. The second discontinuity occurs when k equal to 2 pi by a. So here again discontinuity occurs, then the energy starts from here. It will be like this. Here it will start from here. So this is the, instead of having a single parabolic curve, we will be having discontinuous curve. That discontinuity occurs at pi by a, 2 pi by a and 3 pi by a, where certain range of alpha A values are not possible, that means a certain range of energies are not possible. So this is the allowed energy level, this is allowed. Then this region is allowed, this is allowed energy level, allowed. This region is forbidden, here it is forbidden. This is energy gap. Wave-like solution for electron is not possible for energy value between these two points. Again allowed region, this region is forbidden, then this region it is allowed, and so on. Now we will take another atom. I am taking another atom, let it be its origin be at this point. Then similar to this curve, we can draw a curve here. So this curve, if I am taking another atom here, whose k value is 0 at this point, then its curve will be like this. Then discontinuity occurs here, and the second part we can draw from here. So this is for this one. Then another discontinuity occurs here, then we can draw here. Then here discontinuity occurs, next curve we can draw like this. If I have another atom here, then in a similar way we can draw the curve here as then discontinuity occurs here, then the next variation of energy is this one. Discontinuity occurs here, then the next variation is like this. Discontinuity occurs here, then next variation is like this. Discontinuity occurs here, next variation, and so on. We can write like this. If an atom is at this point, then its curve will be like this. This curve will be like this, then discontinuity occurs here, then we will be having a curve like this. Discontinuity occurs here, then we will be having a curve like this. If I have another atom at this point, then we will be having a curve like this. Then discontinuity occurs here, then we are having like this. Discontinuity occurs here, then we are having like this. So this scheme of representing is called the extended scheme. Extended sort scheme. So this representation is called the extended sort scheme. For this curve we are having this one, then this one. Like that, if we have many number of atomic positions, then we will be having a pattern like this. This is energy versus E versus K graph. And this is the extended sound scheme. We can reduce this to reduced, so we can represent this in reduced sound scheme. For that, see this curve, first we have drawn this curve and its discontinuity occurs here, then we are having this one. If we apply a lattice translation operator to this one, if I add a quantity g to this one, we can transform this, we can change this to this place. If I take a lattice translation operator g of length as shown in figure and minusing from taking the negative minus g, adding minus g to this one, we will be getting this curve. So we can shift this curve to this point. Likewise, this one, this curve we can shift to this one. Here we are minusing g and here we are adding g. So we can shift, we can represent this at this region and this one at this region. That means all the curves can be represented in a single zone, or this is first Brillouin zone. We can represent this all the curves in first zone, then it is called reduced zone scheme. This one we can represent, we can shift to this point, and in a similar way this curve we can shift to this point. So in reduced scheme we are having a representation like this. So this is the variation of E versus K in reduced scheme representation. Actually this curve is for here, one discontinuity is there, this curve is represented here, and we are having, after discontinuity we are having a curve like this, this one is represented here, and the extended scheme we are reducing to first zone, first Brillouin zone, then it is called reduced zone. Okay, thank you.